Hi, I'm Greg DiMichele. I'm a director of product management here at Google, and I work on the Google Cloud platform. Today, we have some exciting news about Compute Engine we want to share with you. Compute Engine is Google's virtual machine technology. It allows you to run any type of application you want on top of Google's infrastructure and data centers. Now, the cloud platform also includes App Engine, which is our platform as a service offering that lets you easily build and scale web apps or mobile backends. We also have a variety of storage products from SQL to NoSQL databases, and all of these are managed and operated by Google using our 15 years of expertise in building hardware and software infrastructure. And if you take it all together, they give you the flexibility you need to build and deploy virtually any type of application. But today, we're here to talk about Compute Engine. This is a big day for Compute Engine and for the cloud platform because we've reached a new milestone. I'm excited to announce that Compute Engine has reached general availability. What that means is you now have virtual machines that have the performance, reliability, security, and scale of Google's own infrastructure. In addition to customer support and a high monthly SLA, this milestone represents our internal and external commitment to the service and to delivering to you a great developer experience. We have over 1,000 engineers working on continuing to make the cloud platform better for Google itself and for you, our customers. Now, before we go too far in looking at new features that we're announcing, let me give you a tour of just what sort of performance and reliability you can expect from Compute Engine. This is a little app that will spawn a number of Compute Engine virtual machines. In this case, I'm going to have it start 1,000 virtual machines. When I click Start, it's using the Compute Engine APIs to launch those virtual machines, and it has a timer running to keep track of how long it took. As the virtual machines are launched, the boxes turn from gray to green, indicating that the VM has launched successfully. Now, this will take a couple minutes to launch these 1,000 virtual machines, so we're going to let that run in the background while I continue to talk to you a bit. Let's talk about some of the new features that we're announcing today. First, Compute Engine now supports transparent maintenance windows. What this means is that as we do the maintenance and upgrades, whether it's software or hardware or networking in our data centers, your application continues to run unimpacted. We move your virtual machine out of the way while we're performing the maintenance. You get the benefits of an up-to-date, maintained, patched data center without having the impact on your applications. This is available today in our United States data centers, and we'll be rolling it out to Europe shortly. In addition, we have automatic restarts. This means in the event of an unplanned event or a hardware failure, your application will restart as quickly as possible. This was a commonly requested feature from many of our customers, including some of our enterprise customers. Now, turning to operating systems, until now we've supported Debian and CentOS-based virtual machines. Well, today we're opening that up. Not only can you run free BSD, you can run any out-of-the-box Linux distro. And with one click in the admin console, you can launch SUSE or Red Hat virtual machines directly. SUSE and Red Hat are in limited preview, and the other Linux distros are available today. We've also added new, more powerful Compute Engine instance types. We know there's customers out there who want to run even more demanding compute-intensive applications. So starting today, you can launch virtual machines with up to 16 cores. These are available in our standard, high CPU, and high memory configurations. This means you can bring even more demanding loads onto Compute Engine. Now, of course, app performance isn't just about number of cores and memory, it also is about disk performance. We know from talking to customers that persistent disk performance is a key factor. So, starting today, persistent disk is up to 8 times faster. This means you can now bring your more IO-intensive and disk-intensive workloads to Compute Engine and have a great experience running those as well. Now, before we go on, let's go over and see how those virtual machines that we started up are doing. Here we are, we're back, and all the boxes have turned green, which means all 1,000 VMs are up and running. And if we look at the time, it was 2 minutes 41 seconds. That's a pretty quick way to start 1,000 VMs. So in addition to new features, We also continue to support major enterprise customers. We have 24/7 support, a monthly SLA of 99.95%, so you have guarantees of uptime, as well as important certifications such as ISO 27001 or SOC 1, 2, and 3. Finally, we're continuing to pass on the savings from building and operating ever more efficient data centers. We're also reaffirming our commitment to offer the best compute price performance. We're doing that by lowering prices on our most popular instance type by 10% across the board in all regions. We've also heard from customers that cost predictability and I/O performance are key factors for persistent disk. So not only are we making it 8 times faster, we're making it up to 60% cheaper. We're also eliminating any charge for I/O. You simply purchase the capacity you need and you get great I/O for free. You get way more performance at a great and predictable price. Of course, when you're building an application, support for partners and ISVs is critical. The ecosystem around Compute Engine is large and growing quickly. The software you're familiar with, whether it's from WriteScale or Scalar, New Relic, MapR, Mongo Labs, all runs great on Google Cloud Platform. Google Cloud Platform gives you the performance, reliability, scalability, and security that we expect from our own applications. You can get started today with Compute Engine and the Google Cloud Platform. Just go to cloud.google.com, sign up for a new account, and you can start creating applications. You know, one of the most fun things about working on the Cloud Platform is seeing the amazing apps that you, the developers, create. So I hope you'll go out, create some great applications, engage with us on Google+ or any of the other social networks. We love hearing about what you've built with the platform. Thanks for listening.